Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. Now, this is fun for me, this part of it. Okay. And it's probably fun for you too. If you've ever started a business and you, the first thing you do is like, okay, I've got to create a name and then I'm going to get a business card. And then you start looking at equipment for whatever tools, whatever you need. Right. And you're like, oh, do I get the nice DeWalt tool bag with all the pockets or whatever it is, right? The Stanley tool bag or Milwaukee, whatever. Well, with this business, it's the same kind of feeling. We kind of jump the gun, you know. Us type A personalities, we shoot first and then, you know, aim later type deal. So what I want to talk to you about is how do you make those decisions the smartest way, and what other options are there in that decision? So is your decision going to pigeonhole you? So if I buy a lemonade press, does it pigeonhole me? Yeah, it means I'm doing lemonades or some kind of citrus, or I'm squeezing onions. You know, it kind of limits me, right? I'm not saying that's a bad thing, but I want you to think about all the things that could be a part of that decision. So I'm going to just put some stuff in your head so that you can go, oh, dang, I never thought about that. Now, check this out. Hot dog carts, I've been selling for years and years and years, right? Almost a decade and a half. And so I have hot dog carts, but you rarely hear me talk about those. And I talk about street food vending and lemonade vending and donut vending. And I talk about all the other forms, but I love that part of the business, but the hot dogs is what saved my life. Wrote a book about it. Okay. Reminds me of that dude that says, wrote a song about it. Here, you want to hear it? Here it goes. So I wanted to share what a hot dog cart means, because it's not just a hot dog cart. It is literally what you would walk into any restaurant and see as far as a steam table, maybe a grill or a griddle or a deep fryer or whatever. And I'm fixing to show you some. But I want you to kind of think about outside the box and go, is this a hot dog cart or is it a mini mobile kitchen? It's a mini mobile kitchen. Okay. That's what I hope you come to, the conclusion you come to. That's how you'll pass the test. So what I want you to do is look at that and go, okay, I see where Ben's going with this. So I could like have soup, just a soup cart. Well, yeah. Could I just do pasta? Yeah. Could I just do like the feller we interviewed in Washington State, who does nothing but baked potatoes? It's a baked potato cart. He's got baked potatoes and all the toppings, right? So depends on your state and your rules and stuff, and I cover all that for you, but I'm gonna do more of it. But just, this is about the cart, the exciting part. I need my stuff. I need my business name and my business card and my cart, right? But that cart's going to make a difference on what happens. And I'm not going to push any certain cart or type of cart. I'm just going to give you enough information to make you dangerous, right? Enough stuff so that you go, I never thought about that. Will my state allow a deep fryer on a cart? Probably not. But they will if it's catering. And that's the next thing I wanted to get to. Catering is so cool. So used to, everybody that ordered anything with a deep fryer off my website, hotdogcartstore.com, just a little plug there. I would call them, hey, dude, you know in Arizona you can't have no freaking deep fryer. You can't have that on your cart. And they'd be like, oh, Ben, I didn't know. Or Ben, dude, I'm three steps ahead of you, which isn't a surprise. I'm from Tennessee, right? So you grade me on a curve. But the point is that they're catering. They're catering. And so many states allow catering, some without a license or some with just a business license, but no health department. And some, here's one that I shared recently. And I've got articles with all the states on all this, right? And I talked to you yesterday about some of this with the kitcheninincome.com. Remember that, kitcheninincome.com. Go check it out. So anyway, they go, okay, I'm going to... like in North Carolina, give you an idea. North Carolina says, you don't need a license. If you're making the food at their house on your equipment, we don't care. Go cater. Well, I took my youngest daughter of 7, and that's what she did. She made a good living in high school doing that. So that's the kind of stuff you can do. And when I say a good living, she made an adult's living with that. So you can do the same thing. And so... a lot of times it comes down to what the variables are and what do you want to do with it. you may be going, well, Ben, you always talk about hot dogs. You're the hot dog man, and hot dogs saved your life, and now you're telling me I can do noodles from a freaking cart. Now you're confusing me. Don't be confused. I show you how in the free training at learnhotdogs.com. It's right here on the thing right there. And it shows you what steps to do. And one of those steps is just call the health department and go, what am I allowed to do? Well, am I allowed to cater? Can I cater without a commercial kitchen? Or do I need a commercial kitchen? Some do, some don't. It doesn't matter. It's all easy stuff, and I give you the steps to get through it all. It, you know, if you were gonna do any business, there's always red tape. But it seems that we go, oh, Ben told me this is going to be easy. I didn't say it wasn't going to be work, though. It's going to be easy, but it's going to still be work. It's going to require a couple phone calls, okay? Thumb's going to hurt, you know, maybe your pointer finger, trying to dial a number and ask some questions. It's not hard. And then when you get down to the finding a commissary, commissary is just a commercial kitchen. Some states say if you're going to be doing cooking in for other people for a retail environment, you have to have a commercial kitchen. Well, ain't none of us got $200,000 to build a commercial kitchen, okay? So we just go borrow one, and there's lots of them out there. There's literally websites where you can just rent one for an hour. So that's how you do it. So, and I teach you that too. I've got the links to those, okay? I've got it all for you. It's free. You don't have to buy nothing. So just go do it. Now, let me show you a cart. Here's just the basic, and I've had a lot of people do this, because I started building a cart. Our first cart was a cash cow cart. I called it cash cow because it was a cash cow. It made money. As long as you put it out there, you making money. So I'm going to share you the cash cow, and then I'll come back to maybe this is it. There, that's the build a cart. Okay, so maybe I didn't pull it up. Either way, that is the build a cart cart. Okay, and I don't like me being disappeared, so I'm going to do this. Okay, there me is. So here's the deal. I got two me's on the screen. Anyway, that is the cash cow basically, but in a DIY form. So you build it. We teach you how to build it. We can sell you all the stuff for it pretty much, or the stuff that you can get locally. You don't need to go through me. But some of the stuff you may go, Ben, I need the pans already drilled, blah, blah, blah. We sell it. We sell it as a kit. Okay, and you can buy part of a kit, whole kit, you can do whatever you want, but you can go to buildacart.com, which is, I think, right here, buildacart.com. And you can go to buildacart.com and watch the video and see what we've done with these and see what others have done. Some have just modified them, put grills and griddles and stuff on them, deep fryers even. So that is a basic one that you can build for about, it used to be under $900, now it's about $1,200 because of inflation. I don't know if you've noticed. So everything's gone up. So about $1,200, maybe $1,500 if you really go, you know, super shiny. You can build this cart complete with a water system, powered water system, self-contained. It's a mobile kitchen, okay? Legal in all 50 states. So you can do this, right? And save yourself some money. Or you can go, hey, I can do this and let this buy my next cart. I can do this and it buys my Big Dog or my Cater Pro or whatever fandangled thing you find, right? And you go, okay, I'm going to let this buy my next one. Then I'll rent this one out, or I'll use it for my catering jobs, or I'll rent it for my drop-off catering. And you're going, what? Did Ben just say drop-off catering? That sounds cool. You don't have a clue what it is, probably, but it is kind of cool. Now, two of me is just not going to work. So you would go, okay, drop-off catering is where somebody, and I did this, and we've recorded vendors their whole process from deciding to do it to doing it. But anyway, you go, drop-off catering. What is that? So basically, somebody calls and goes, hey, I'd love to rent your cart. It's a mobile mini mobile kitchen, right? We're going to be up in Sundance in Utah doing a family reunion. We'd love to have a cooking stuff so we can cook and clean up. I got you. You can rent it. $400 for the day. $300 for the day. I was renting mine way cheaper than that back in the day. I was renting mine for about $50 a day and then a cleanup fee. But it was working, right? And I started renting carts to just people coming to the mountains going, hey, we ain't never been to Pigeon Forge. Are we going to see Dolly Parton? And we want to go up in Gatlinburg because we heard there's bears and you can pet them. And so they'd want to take a cart up there to the river and do a little cookout and stuff. So I rented carts. And they'd be able to have their own little cooking apparatus, or apparatus kitchen, all in one little towable thing, right? It's just like renting a U-Haul. It was beautiful. So, and vendors are still doing that. So then you have a backup plan for it when you're not going to use it as your main source of income, or you're going to sideline it for gigs, private gigs, whatever. You're going to send your sister-in-law to a party to do because it's a small birthday party and she's going to be serving hot dogs, and you charge them $450 to serve 65 hot dogs and some chili and stuff. And literally, when I'm saying this, vendors are doing this. Daily, vendors are doing this. I wish you were in our Vendors United group, because you'd actually see vendors doing this daily. You'd hear about it, like Keith last night and his monstrous weekend with his wife, Mary. So this is what we're doing. So then you go, okay, I'm going to buy a different cart. Let me show you another cart, okay? This is a big dog, and this is my favorite cart probably, and I'm a little biased. But let me see if I can get that to be better. There it is. How's that for better? Okay, so I'm not there anymore, but you see what I'm saying. I'm going to make myself there because I've got ego. So there I am, and there's the big dog. It's got a flip-top lid, double steam table. It's got so many arrangements of that steam table, and we walk you through every arrangement you can possibly do for free. It's on the website now. You can just go look. Michael Wood has done it. Mark Lawler's done it. Jason Brown's done it. Corey Lawrence has done it. You get my point. A lot of people have done walk-arounds and different ways to set up pans. Plus, I've done it. So you have a grill. You've got a fridge if you want a fridge. You can do whatever, all kinds of stuff with this cart. It is a mini mobile kitchen. And it's approved in all 50 states. Now, there's a little variation. Some states go, well, the grill needs to be on the side. Or, hey, you need to have a splash guard between the first and the second sink, whatever. This cart has four sinks. So you go, once you know your standards, you just order it that way. But we have big dogs in all states. We have them in about 70 countries, 72 countries. So this is a great cart, and it acts as a full service. It will outwork you. So you can't possibly outwork this cart. It will make more food faster than you can serve. So a lot of times you've seen me do videos with vendors, and they got two people running the cart. One taking money, one cooking. One taking money, one cooking. And it's just crazy. I went to Panama City Beach, one of these, and the feller's there working the cart, right? And he's got a lady walking up and down the line of people, okay, taking their money and their order instantly. And one, it keeps them from jumping out of line because they already paid, right? And then it gives him the orders quicker. And so he was just making orders. So this is a fantastic cart. And you get into the catering with this is fantastic because you can do everything. I've done noodle bars. I've done soup bars off of it. I've done even just crazy stuff like mashed potato and cornbread and all kinds of stuff right off of here. Did I cook it all there? No. Heck no. It ain't an oven. Okay. But it keeps it all hot. Now, let me show you another one. I'm going to turn that one off. I'm going to turn that one off, and I'm going to turn the big dog off. This one you're going to love. Okay, look at this cart. Okay, I got to make this bigger. Okay, and then I got to get rid of part of me because that's ridiculous. Okay, look how big this cart is. This is a huge cart, okay, that has double steam tables, roll tops, a commercial griddle, a commercial deep fryer, a refrigerator, a grill on the end. It's got everything. I mean, this is just a rolling monstrosity. Does it work everywhere? No. This is one I was telling you about at the beginning where I said, hey, you got to pay attention because I'll call somebody and go, hey, John, dude, you're in New Mexico. They don't allow deep fryer. And John goes, Ben, I'm catering, man. I'm just catering. And a lot of people just cater. And that's how they get away with using some monstrosity of a cart like this. It is awesome. And it's awesome to pull up because they know you're loaded for bear when you pull up in this. But it is a fantastic cart. You'll find all these carts at hotdogcartstore.com. I didn't even put it on here. I didn't come on here to pitch the stuff that I had here. I had a little red thing here. I don't know where it went. buildacart.com. So if you want to build a cart, boop, right, I think, yeah, there's your links, okay? So that gives you, that may expand your mind. And if you got questions, send them to me, okay? Ben@learnhotdogs.com. Ben@learnhotdogs.com. I will type in real quick. I'm going to just type in real quick, okay? This is how quick I can do this on the fly. This is on the fly. Or on the turtle, because I'm a little slower than that. Okay, this is the place. If you want to join Vendors United, you can join for free, okay? And try it out, okay? Take it for a spin, kick the tires. And you're going to meet hundreds of vendors who are willing to help you at every moment's notice. They're all doing what you're doing or wanting to do. Some of them just started. Some of them ain't started yet. Some of them breaking out with extra carts. Some of them with 16 carts. Some of them with nothing but commissary businesses. They're all helping each other, from kettle corn to popcorn to cottage food to kitchen income to no matter what, they're in there helping each other. We do 2 meetings a week, private meetings, because we have secrets. We have secrets. There's secrets in this business. So it's just a great place to get lots of information quick. So you may be going, hey, dude, my supplier ran out of such and such. What's a good substitute for such and such? And boom, 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 you got answers. Or, hey, how do I prepare for this event? There's going to be 9,300 people there that are expecting or sold tickets for, and I'm the only vendor. How many hot dogs do I take? How many sausages? How many of this? How many of that? We help you do that. So anyway, what I love about this business is all the variables, all the things you can do. I had a buddy started out vending hot dogs, just vending hot dogs in Asheville, North Carolina. And then he goes, he's paying for a commissary. And then he decided, hey, I'd like to just have my own commissary. He saw me do it. I did it. I did my own commissary. Then I started renting my commissary to other vendors and was making extra money. And then Jason Brown did it and made a huge business out of that. And then this guy in Asheville goes, I think I'll just do a commissary. He got it up. He's making 10, 11 grand a month with a commissary. And he's like, Ben, I think I'm going to just quit vending. I'm making good money with the commissary. And I said, absolutely. And he was giving fair prices to other vendors. So he made it even better. He limited competition. And then he created, because he took himself out of the role in his carts. And then he just started renting his commissary. Now he's got 2 commissaries, kicking butt. So there's so many variables to this business. But you got to start somewhere. You got to start where you can afford to start. And you got to start smart. You got to think ahead a little bit. So you may go, you know what? I'm going to start this part-time. I'm going to start this part-time on a limited basis like Michael Wood did 12 years ago, 13 years ago. And we have all of his stuff. You'll be able to talk to Michael Wood in the group. So anyway, Michael started at 3 days a month. Well, then it started doing real good. And he's like, well, dang, I shouldn't probably be working over here anymore because I'm making more here than I am in 2 weeks over here. And all of a sudden, things change. And then you go, well, catering, huh, I can make a gob catering. So Michael Wood is doing so good catering, private. When I say catering, I don't mean somebody calls you up and, hey, we got a wedding. That happens too, but we got a wedding we want you to do. No, this is like private event catering. So the Ford dealership where he is goes, hey, Michael Wood, we love your hot dogs. Our boys eat down there when you're across from McDonald's all the time from you. We'd love you to come here every Saturday. We'll pay you to be here, and you keep the money. And he's like, okay. Well, he was there so many freaking years that they made a mural. Is that the word? Yeah, mural. It's a painting. Painting on the wall of the dealership, you know, with cars out in the lot. A hand-painted painting. And in it is Michael Wood with his big dog cart. That big dog cart I showed you. Not the Cater Pro. Just the basic big dog with a grill. That was it. So, and he's in a little podunk town in Georgia. Okay, so where everybody's kin. Anyway, I love you. I just wanted to inspire you and give you the knowledge so that you made the right path decision and to think ahead. Sometimes we don't have many choices. Like sometimes we walk into the car dealership and we don't get to pick our choice of cars we want. It's like, what do you have under $1,500? What needs a starter that's fixing to go to the junk pile that maybe I can fix with my brother-in-law? That's okay too, but you still, while you're looking for it, you may be going, man, I can get this Buick Century station wagon. That'd be great, but for $200 more, I can get that old pickup truck that needs a starter And now I can haul firewood on the weekend. So now it not only gets me to my job, it creates new income. That's what I wanted to share with you. I love you, and I'll talk to you soon. Thanks for being here. And remember, you can always reach out to me, Ben at learnhotdogs.com, and I'll try to answer you as fast as I can and get a lot of them.